So I got a simple hack for you today, and that's masking and keeping a roll of tape with you so you don't have to go look for it everywhere when you're doing your masking. So I just keep a roll of tape right on my wrist, just like this, keep the tape coming over the top, and now I can mask and not have to carry around a roll of tape in my mouth or someplace else. If I do any type of masking, it's very simple and effective and fast. All I could do is just grab my tape, and I can just now tape just like this. Very effective way of masking and not losing your tape. All you gotta do is just stick your hand right through it. I know some people got hands that are too big, might not be able to fit in the roll, but it works just like that. You wanna make sure the tape is coming over the top of your wrist, just like this, versus under. Otherwise, the tape is gonna twist just over the top. Now I can just effectively, quickly mask without hunting around for a roll of tape. It's always with me wherever I go. So here's a simple little hack with a masker and paper and tape right here. I've got this bathtub right here. I'm gonna be rolling these walls. I don't have plastic and I don't have enough drop cloths to cover in here. And so I don't want any stippling to come down on their shampoo and stuff like that. I'm not gonna bother moving it out because it's just a small area. But just take some paper just like this and I'll make a stipple catcher. All I gotta do is get some paper out here. You can see how underneath, I've just tacked it underneath. I've made a crease, folded it, and it keeps it up in the air. You don't even have to actually crease it. I can just take just like that, just in a couple areas. It's about right in the middle of the paper, and it holds it up. And that will catch any stipple that the roller may splatter down. I use a high-end roller from Premier. It's a Coda wool roller, and I'm using a high-end paint that typically doesn't stipple at all, but there you go. You got yourself a little catcher. I'm not gonna get any stippling, any paint splatter down on any of these, the soaps or shampoos or anything inside the bathtub. So I got a simple little hack for you, and it's how to pour paint out of a gallon or a 5 gallon bucket without making a big mess or getting paint all on the bottom of the bucket or your tin. So what you wanna do is always have a brush with you, because that's what you're gonna take and wipe up the paint from the side that gets a little bit on the side, and it's how you scrape it out of the top of the can. Need about a quart of paint in here, a pint of paint. And part of it is just pouring quickly and snapping it back quickly. So I wanna pour it in here, and then I'm just gonna take and let it run out right here until it stops dripping. And I'm just gonna snap it back. It flicks a little bit on the side. Now I'm just gonna wipe that off the side. I'm gonna take my brush, pull it out of the top of the can, scrape it into my can. Now the top of the can is all clean, so when I put my lid in there, it's not gonna get all sealed in there and glued on. The side doesn't have any paint that's gonna run down, pool along the edges, so I can set it down now on my surface, and I'm not gonna make a big mess. A simple little hack how to pour paint out of a 5 or a single without making a big mess. Got a quick tip for you today, and that's rolling walls and how to keep your paint from dripping. I'm in another part of the house, moved out here just to show you this handy little tip. So when you're rolling a wall and you're loading up your nap, instead of loading up your nap and just taking and carrying it now to the wall, there's great odds that the nap is gonna drip. So what I do is I load up my nap, and as soon as I load up my nap, I begin spinning my nap, and I consciously or subconsciously spin the nap as I'm going to my wall or wherever I'm taking it. As long as you're rotating and spinning that nap, no matter how loaded that thing is, it's not gonna drip. So I can sit here and spin it. If I need to take it over here, just spin it slowly. If you spin it too fast, you could flick paint off the nap. So simple little trick to keeping paint from dripping off your nap. Here's a simple little hack for you, and it's pre-wetting your brush prior to using it, because it's gonna make it a lot easier to clean at the end of the day or when you're done using it. I just drop it into a bucket of clean water, and then I just tap it out on my shoe right here to get the excess water out of it.
just like this. Don't tap too hard because you'll end up bending the ferrule, but just like that. Now it's pre-wetted, ready to go. And what that does is puts moisture on the bristles so the paint itself doesn't bite and absorb to the bristles and make it a lot harder to clean at the end of the day. Simple little hack, pre-wetting your brush prior to using it. So that's the end. 5 more really cool painting hacks for you. Hopefully you guys enjoyed them. If you have, give us a thumbs up, hit the notification bell. That way you'll get notified next time I come out with some really cool painting hacks. It's free, simple, and easy to do. It doesn't cost anything to subscribe. Check us out on Instagram and Facebook, where we got other really cool simple hacks and little short videos and just whatever we're doing out there, you know, around and about. We'll see you on our next video. Out.